So let's talk about streamers. Oh wait, not gaming streamers, but music hardware streamers. Because this, my friends, is the WiiM Mini, which costs only about 499 ringgit or 99 USD. And apparently, this is becoming more of a favorite compared to this Bluesound NODE that costs 2,899 ringgit and 599 USD. Huh? What the fuck? Like, you know, a puck. Well, let's find out if the WiiM Mini is bigger than we think it is. So in the box for the WiiM Mini, there is the optical cable, a 3.5mm to 3.5mm AUX cable, and a 3.5mm to 2RCA cable. So yes, there's no power brick inside of the box because it powers through the USB-C port, which only needs about 5 volts of power. Then as for the Bluesound NODE inside of the box, you'll find a 2-pin power cord, an Ethernet cable, a stereo RCA to RCA cable, and an optical to 3.5mm jack mini adapter. So both streamers have a wholly different design language and form factors. The WiiM Mini takes a hockey puck form factor. Much like the Google Chromecast Audio, it is small, it fits in your hand and also in your pocket as well. Where it has a plastic build but very solid, and it weighs at 40 grams and it measures at just 69 by 24 millimeters. Now on top is where you'll find the controls for the play and pause, volume control as well. Then there's also the 3-color LED status light. Then at the side there are the analog inputs and output spots, or AUX with full support of 192 kHz and 24-bit audio, a USB-C port for charging, and a TOS link or an optical cable port for 16-bit 48 kHz audio for connecting it to a DAC. So yes, that's it. It's very simple and quite nice. Now on the other hand, the Bluesound NODE is completely a different animal. It has a sleek rectangular shape, almost looking like a TV decoder-like, and of course has a way larger form factor than the WiiM Mini. It comes with either black or white with a satin matte finish on top, and it measures at 220 by 46 by 146 millimeters, weighing at 2.28 kgs. Now when compared, it has a premium build and finish, and of course on top is where I really love the glass touch panel, which was pretty neat, where the panel is built in with a proximity sensor. So if you go close to the Bluesound NODE, it will light up the status light LED. Then there are 5 programmable soft touch buttons as well, like the play pause, volume slider and the skip track buttons. Then on the front panel, it is kept very clean with just the 3.5mm headphones jack and also the IR receiver. But on the back though is where you'll find a crazy amount of ports for this Bluesound NODE. From left to right, you'll find the analog RCA audio out, and this is for the left and the right channels, the subwoofer out, the coaxial out, optical in or analog in, a trigger out, an IR in, an Ethernet port, a USB-A port, a HDMI ERC port, and of course the power socket as well. So from the spots alone, you can tell that the Bluesound NODE is quite a different beast. And it can be much more than just a streamer, which allows you to connect to your TV, your soundbar, or even your home AV setup. And with the existence of the HDMI ERC, it means that you can pass through high bit rate audio and video, including technology like Dolby Atmos and Dolby Vision, and you'll be able to share a single remote for your TV and also your NODE as well. Now speaking of remote control, neither of these streamers comes with a physical remote inside of the box, where it is truly app driven. So who wins here in terms of the design and build quality? Well, it all depends on what exactly that you need in a streamer. If you want something truly simple and plug and play, and of course being compact, the WiiM Mini wins at any day because of the smaller and the compact form factor, which doesn't scream like, hey, I'm a music streamer. No, it doesn't. But if you're looking for a more extensive features like connecting it to a TV and a home entertainment setup, then the NODE would claim the throne because of its solid and a heavy build quality. Okay, so as for the comparison and the hardware features, here's where things get quite interesting. Both packs everything that you need to enjoy high-res audio streaming, but the Bluesound NODE offering a bit more extra. First, let's start with the WiiM Mini. It offers dual band Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5.0 that supports SBC and AAC codecs. And these are the only two ways to be connected to your network since there is no Ethernet port. And is baked with services like Spotify Connect, Tidal Connect, and AirPlay 2 with gapless playback. And it also works with virtual assistants like Siri and Amazon Alexa. Sorry if I triggered your device. Now, it supports many of the top music streaming services out of the box like Spotify, TuneIn, Deezer, iHeartRadio, Amazon Music, and more. And the cool thing is that you can basically play music from any source offline if you have made a purchase of any, of course, which supports FLAC and also MP3 files. And by the way, the WiiM Mini will happily play most of the audio codecs, including MP3, AAC, ALAC, APE, FLAC, WAVE, WMA, and OGG. Now, inside this little thing is a powerful integrated TI stereo DAC that supports up to 192 kHz, 24-bit audio, so it is already capable of excellent audio quality out of the box. However, you can still connect it to an external DAC if you want to upgrade the audio performance, just like the audiophile YouTuber Darko Audio, where he has paired the WiiM Mini together with the Cord Mojo DAC, which produce better sound quality than the Bluesound NODE. Interesting. Next, on the Bluesound NODE, there is a reason why this is the world's most popular streamer, music streamer, as it has a quite incredible package with outstanding features and superb audio quality. Now, for connectivity, the NODE supports dual band Wi-Fi 5 and two-way Bluetooth aptX HD that ensures playbacks without any interruption. Now, unlike the WiiM Mini, it has the added advantage of a built-in Gigabyte Ethernet port, which gives you a more stable and, of course, a better connectivity option. Now, under the hood, it has a powerful 32-bit 384 kHz DAC and powered by the quad-core 1.8 GHz ARM processor. And it's so powerful that you can actually use this as a preamp in your AV setup. Now, like the WiiM Mini, it also has AirPlay 2, Spotify Connect, as well as being Rune ready. It also has support for Amazon Alexa, Siri, and also Google Assistant. And of course, when it comes to the streaming services, it has the ever-expanding list, which includes Spotify, TuneIn, iHeartRadio, SiriusXM for US and Canada only, Amazon Music, Deezer, KKBOX, and more. And like the WiiM Mini, it also plays almost any audio format that you throw at it, including the added MQA, also known as the Master Quality Authenticated, which should make many audiophiles happy. Now, while it does not come with an IR remote inside of the box, it does, however, have IR capabilities built in, where you can also buy the Bluesound RC1 remote controller separately for $60. So for the winner of this one is, of course, the Bluesound NODE for the higher res audio and, of course, the better connectivity. So both streamers are app-driven, as mentioned earlier. Now, on the WiiM Mini, you'll need to download the WiiM Home app, which is available both for Android and iOS devices. Now, the setup process is pretty simple and straightforward. Your new WiiM Mini will pop up automatically in the app, and all you have to do is just to follow the in-app guide, and you'll be up and running in just 2 minutes. So easy and quite Apple-like. Now, via the app, you can manage and control your entire audio experience from building a multi-room system with several AirPlay 2 speakers and also other WiiM Minis. And you can also automate your life with your favorite virtual assistants like Siri or even Alexa. Now, you can of course change the EQ settings in the app too for a more personalized listening. Now, speaking of which, the app also has the adaptive EQ that intelligently adjusts the frequencies in real time to deliver a better listening experience depending on the type of music that you're listening to. Now, audio synchronization is perfect and seamless, and the WiiM Mini offers precise gapless playback, a feature that is crucial for continuous music playback, especially when you're playing a live concert recording or some classical music, to have a seamless transition between the songs. Now, I must say that the audio performance was surprisingly good, and having tested with the Kanto Tuck speakers that I have during this review period, which is my current favorite speakers this year, which I've done a video on that, so do check it out over here if you haven't done so. Now, I also found that the app was quite intuitive and problem-free, and connectivity-wise, no noticeable latency issues during playback. And I like how the WiiM Mini is quite straightforward. You just plug in a cable, fire up the app, and you're all set. Now, moving on to the Bluesound NODE, it is powered by the Blue OS, which is the only platform in the world that supports up to 64 players and all streaming 24-bit audio. Now, if I only could afford 64 players, right? Then the Blue OS app is available for iOS, Android, Windows, Mac OS, and of course the setup of the Node itself is pretty straightforward and fast as well. Now the app is quite intuitive and also fully featured, and it allows you to connect and manage your music library, whether with popular music services or even stored in your computer or your external hard drive. And what I really love about the Node is of course the Ethernet port, because that is something that a lot of people, including audiophiles, would really appreciate, as this ensures reliable tethered connectivity instead of just only relying on Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, which could be a little unstable. And the touch panel controls works well, and the proximity sensor is very responsive. Now, when it comes to the audio performance, the Node is quite perfect and also truly gapless. And I'm quite surprised that the stream music can sound this good on the Bluesound Node. And I found that music playback was neutral sounding and precise and clear, with excellent details all over. And I think that this would be a perfect companion to your TV or your soundbar if you're looking beyond having a multi-room high-res music system. So overall, it's quite a close battle when it comes to the user experience, which sounds very funny because the huge price difference. Because guys, ultimately, being a more power-packed in terms of the hardware of the two, the Bluesound Node comes on top when it comes to the overall quality and of course, the audio performance. The verdict. So having tested the WiiM Mini and also the Node for several weeks, I've come to like it for different reasons. The WiiM Mini is fuss-free, compact, amazingly simple, yet packs a punch when it comes to delivering the audio performance that really matters. And it's also super affordable, and I highly recommend this for most people. Then with the Bluesound Mode, yes, it costs so much more than a WiiM Mini, but if you think about it, they shouldn't even be in the same category. And then you might think, why in the world are you comparing this to then? Well, if you read between the lines, the Node offers more. It offers higher bitrate audio, more connectivity options, and with a wider support for players. But on the flip side, it will take up more space on your shelf or your TV cabinet. But if you're serious about audio, have more space there. So in conclusion, it really does boil down to what is your budget and of course, what are your requirements. Both delivers what you expect and even more. And the reason of me presenting this video is to help you make a choice on what exactly that you need. And speaking of getting the devices, both the Bluesound Node and also the WiiM Mini is available on TechX Store, as TechX is the exclusive distributor for WiiM in Malaysia and the authorized dealer for Bluesound. And just for you who are watching, you can enjoy a 15% discount for the WiiM Mini and also a 10% discount for the Bluesound Node by using the promo code down in the description below, so do check it out over there. So with everything that I've compared and shown to you, I would like to know, what do you think? And also, what's your choice between these two?